In this lesson, we will learn the differences between TCP and UDP. We will focus on each transport layer protocol and learn the details of them. First of all, TCP and UDP are transport layer protocols. They work at layer 4 of OSI model. Transport layer provides end-to-end communication in computer networks. TCP, UDP, and another transport layer protocol, SCTP, work in this layer. In transport layer, there are multiple sessions for data delivery, so it provides session multiplexing. Network ports are also related with transport layer. Let's remember network ports again. There are three types of network ports: well-known ports from 0 to 1023, registered ports from 1024 to 49,151, and dynamic ports from 49,152 to 65,535. The ports used in transport layer identifies application layer protocol. Let's give an example. Think about that. You are sending data from one PC to another PC with FTP. You have one source port and one destination port. Source is a random port and the destination port is FTP port. Or if you use SSH, your source port will be SSH port and destination port will be random port. This mechanism works for other application layer protocols also. In transport layer, UDP and TCP works here. Let's start with UDP. UDP, User Datagram Protocol. It works on layer 4, transport layer. UDP do not need any session. It is a connectionless protocol. So without any session connection, it starts send data immediately. TCP is not like UDP because TCP needs a session to send data. UDP provides unreliable transfer. There is no guarantee for this data transmission, but it is fast. In other words, UDP provides best effort transfer. UDP has basic error checking. DTLS, Datagram Transport Layer Security, is used for security purposes with UDP. We use UDP for unsensitive traffic and for real-time traffic that are not affected from data loss. Voice over IP, video streaming, video conferencing, and gaming are the traffics that use UDP. In UDP, there is no specific mechanism like TCP. There is no ACK mechanism, no reordering, no retransmission, no guarantee, no flow control, and no window scaling in user datagram protocol mechanism. What about UDP header? Here is the parts of a UDP header. A UDP header is 8 bytes long. It has 4 parts: source port, destination port, length, and checksum. Some applications uses UDP ports. DHCP uses UDP port 67. BootP uses UDP port 68. TFTP uses port 69. NTP uses port 123. SNMP uses port 161 and 162. Syslog uses port 514, and EzaCMP uses UDP port 500. What about TCP? TCP, Transmission Control Protocol. It is a layer 4 protocol. It is a connection-oriented protocol. For TCP transmission, firstly, TCP connection must be established. TCP provides reliable communication. It guarantees data delivery with different mechanisms, but it is slower than UDP. For security, TCP uses SSL/TLS. For error checking, it has more complex mechanism than UDP. It also provides error recovery. We use TCP for sensitive and critical traffic. File transfers, downloads, printing can be such sensitive traffic. Think about this. If we do a file transfer with UDP, and if some packets are lost on the way, can we trust this data? Because UF unguaranteed transfer, some of the part of this transfer can be lost. TCP header is 20 bytes long. With option parts, we can increase this to maximum 60 bytes. There are many fields in a TCP header. These are source and destination ports, sequence number, acknowledgement number, length, flags, window size, checksum, urgent pointer, options, and padding. Here is the most important mechanism of TCP, three-way handshake. This is the mechanism of TCP session establishment. One side sends a packet by setting SYN bit to 1, and other side receives and sends another packet by setting SYN and ACK bit, or flag, to 1. And lastly, the first sender sends a packet by setting ACK flag to 1. You can check TCP header and the flags parts that is used during this period. We have established our session, and then we send data with TCP. When we need to close our session, TCP four-way handshake is used. In TCP four-way handshake, we set two flags, FIN and ACK flags. And one side, send FIN message to say that I would like to close this session, and another side accept this with ACK message. And it also sends FIN and receives ACK message to close the session. There are different mechanisms used in TCP. One of them is sequence numbers and acknowledgments. ACKs are sent for segments for guaranteed transfer, and if are there any missing segment, it is sent. Another one is reordering. With reordering, received data is ordered at the received end if it is received out of order. And windowing is the mechanism with which we can increase and decrease the sent data rate. Now, let's talk about a little detail-y about these mechanisms. Sequence and ACK mechanism is used for guaranteed delivery. Think about if one side sends 10 bits to the other end, it waits for ACK for the next bit, 11th bit. When it receives this ACK, then it sends the next bits. In this mechanism, sequence numbers are used. The sender side waits a little after it sends the data. If it does not receive any ACK, it sends the same data again. This is retransmission mechanism. During the data transfer, sometimes the data is received out of order at the receiver side. To have a meaningful data, receiver side uses TCP reordering mechanism and orders the data. Another TCP mechanism is window scaling or TCP windowing. With window scaling, TCP determines the data rate. For this example, sender sends the data with a window size 32,768. The maximum segment size of this data is 1,460. So, the sender sends 22 segments before receiving any ACK. After the receiver receives this data, it needs to decrease window size. So it sends an ACK that sends the new window size as 16,384. The sender gets this message and this time it sends 11 segments, totally 16,384 window size. This is basically how TCP window scaling works. Here, the optimum size is determined. What about TCP ports? Here are some of the application protocols that uses TCP ports. FTP uses TCP port 20 and 21, SH uses TCP port 22, Telnet uses port 23, SMTP uses port 25, TACACS uses port 25, 49, HTTP uses port 80, POP3 uses port 110, SFTP uses port 115, and HTTPS uses TCP port 443. Here is the comparison table for TCP and UDP. Let's summarize the difference of these two transport layer protocols. TCP is connection-oriented protocol, UDP is connectionless protocol, TCP is slower, UDP is faster, TCP header is 20 bytes long, while UDP header is only 8 bytes long. TCP uses packet reordered acknowledgement mechanisms, UDP does not use. TCP has error checking and recovery mechanism, but this mechanism is simple in UDP. TCP provides guaranteed transfer, so it is reliable. UDP is not a guaranteed transfer, and it is not reliable. TCP uses SSL/TLS, while UDP uses DTLS. HTTP, HTTPS, and FTP are some protocols that uses TCP ports. DHCP, TFTP, SNMP are some protocols uses UDP ports. Lastly, TCP is mainly used for critical and sensitive traffic, while UDP is mostly used for real-time and unsensitive traffic. This is end of our lesson, and now let's test what you have learned. These questions are also asked in real-time network engineering job interviews. Question 1. How many bytes are there in a UDP header? 4, 8, 12, 20, or 40? This is an easy question for you, and our answer is 8 bytes. Question 2. Which applications uses UDP ports by default? TFTP, DHCP, Telnet, SNMP, and SSH. TFTP, DHCP, and SNMP use UDP ports. Which flags are not used in three-way handshake or four-way handshake? SWIN, URG, FIN, ACK, and PST. URG and PST flags are not used in TCP three-way handshake. Minimum, how many bytes are there in a TCP header? 5, 10, 20, 40, or 60. TCP header has 20 bytes by default. Which applications uses TCP ports by default? FTP, DHCP, SMTP, HTTPS, or SNMP? FTP, SMTP, and HTTPS are the applications that use TCP ports. Which one is not a field of UDP header? Source port, destination port, length, flags, and checksum. There is no flags part in UDP, so our answer is D. Which one is not true for TCP? Slow, layer 4 protocol, secure, connectionless, and reliable. TCP is a connection-oriented protocol, so our answer is D. Which ones are the mechanisms used in TCP? Reordering, sequence numbers, acknowledgements, window scaling, or all of them? All of these mechanisms are sued by TCP. This is end of our lesson. If you like this video, please do not forget to like it and share it with your friends. And also do not forget to subscribe to our channel. Good luck.